Welcome to the second part of our tutorial about drum arrangements. We've already discussed the basics in part 1, so now it is time to see how it can be done in Hookpad. If you are new to this topic, or you want to refresh your memory, I recommend watching part 1 first. Alright, let's start with a new project in Hookpad. By default, Hookpad's band is already set up with a basic pop drum patch. We press B to open the band browser, and then click on that little speaker symbol to unmute the drums. As you can hear, our Hookpad drummer already follows the same basic rules we have discussed in the first video. The snare and the kick play a sequence of low and high notes, the snare is put on count 2 and 4, and the hi-hat plays a small repetitive pattern of eighth notes. But our Hookpad drummer doesn't play any fill-ins yet. In order to do that, we need to use one of the smart patches. In the drum browser, you can find two different kinds of drum rhythms. The ones in the folder called Basic Drums repeat a single groove over and over, whereas all other drum patches follow our smart algorithm to automatically play crash cymbals and fill-ins at the right time. To check it out, let's select the Pop Cymbal 1 patch. We could already hear a crash cymbal at the start. And if we take a look at bar 8, there we have our first fill-in. And at bar 16, there is another one. As 8 bars is the most common length for a song part, our Hookpad drummer plays a fill-in every 8th bar. It will always play a smaller fill-in first, and a bigger one the second time. And of course, following our rules, there is a crash cymbal after each fill-in. Let's see how this works with some music. To make things easier, I imported our demo song from the first video into Hookpad. If you are watching this video on our website, you can find a link to the song to follow along beneath. Now we just heard a fill-in, but it seemed to be at the wrong place. As you might recall from the first video, the fill-in should be placed at the bar where the strings come in, before the start of the new song part. Now what happened here is that our first part indeed has 8 bars, but it begins with a pickup which adds an extra bar to it. So now, in total, we have 9 bars instead of 8. Fortunately, there is a way to tell Hookpad the exact position of the start of a new song part, the band marker. A band marker is usually used to create a separate instrumentation for an individual part of your song. To add a band marker, we first click on the appropriate bar itself, which changes the interface and gives us some new options. At the right, you can find a button called Add Band Change. Here you can also select the bar to set the band marker, but as we have already done that, we can simply click OK. Now the great thing about band markers is that every time our Hookpad drummer sees one, it will automatically play a fill-in at the bar before it and begin the next bar with a crash cymbal. From there, it counts 8 bars again to determine where to put the next fill-in. So once we have solved the problem of the extra pickup bar shifting our arrangement 1 bar to the right, the rest of the song should work pretty well again. Now before we finish this video, let's shortly recall what we have learned so far. All patches in the basic drums folder repeat a single groove over and over. All other drums by default follow a cycle of 8 bars, which starts with a crash cymbal and ends with a fill-in. If you need to break out of the 8-bar cycle, use a band marker. As we have just properly arranged the middle of our song, in the next video we will take a look at its beginning and end. I will show you how to create a pickup fill-in and a proper ending for each instrument. Please leave a comment and hit subscribe. I'm Dennis, and I will see you soon.